In this lecture, we will learn about equivalent stiffness of system, which is combination of beams and springs. But we'll start with a parallel system of springs. And I assume that most of you are familiar with this system. So I will not describe everything in detail, but I will highlight the key aspects that we have to keep in mind. So here we have two springs with stiffnesses K1 and K2 connected in this way, and a force F is acting in downward direction. For this system, we have K equivalent equals to K1 plus K2. Now here, note that what makes these springs in parallel is not their parallel placement, but the property that their displacements are same and their forces are different. Here note that both the springs undergo same displacement x and their forces F1 and F2 are different. So two springs will be considered in parallel if their displacements are same and their forces are different. Similarly, in a series system, we have two springs with stiffness K1 and K2, and their lengths are L1 and L2. So for this system, we have 1 upon K equivalent equals to 1 upon K1 plus 1 upon K2. And this I can also write as K equivalent equals to K1 K2 upon K1 plus K2. And here note that it is not the appearance of the springs being in series makes them in series, but what makes them in series is they both carry same force and their stretchings are different. So if two springs are connected such that under action of force their displacements are different and their forces are same, then the springs will be in series. Now in structural analysis, beams also act like springs because they deform under action of forces. So if we take example of a cantilever beam of length L acted upon by force F in the direction perpendicular to the length of the beam, then the displacement at the free end of the beam YB is given by YB equals to FL cube upon 3EI, or I can write F equals to 3EI upon L cube into YB. Now if I compare this equation with equation F equals to KX, and if X is equals to YB, that is displacement, then I get K equals to 3EI upon L cube. Here note the configuration of our force F and that of the displacement. The force and the displacement are in the same direction, but they are both perpendicular to the length of our beam. So this stiffness is applicable only when force F is acting at the free end of the beam and the displacement that we are considering is also that of free end of the beam. Similarly, in a simply supported beam where force F is acting perpendicular to the beam at the mid span of the beam, then in that case the displacement of mid span, that is YB, is given by FL cube upon 48EI, or that I can write as F equals to 48EI upon L cube into YB. And again, if I compare that with F equals to KX, and if X is equals to YB, then I get K equals to 48EI upon L cube. And here again, note that my force F is acting at the mid span of my beam and the displacement is of the mid span. Next, let's consider a system consisting of cantilever beam with a spring. Here I have my cantilever beam and the spring, and there is a force F acting in the downward direction, and under the action of this force the system will displace like this. Downward displacement of point B is YB. So the downward displacement of free end B of the cantilever is YB in downward direction, and the extension in the length of the spring is also equals to YB. So Here my beam and spring both have same displacement. Now let's look at the forces in the beam and the spring. Here if I draw the free body diagram of joint B, then I have force F acting in the downward direction. Say the force in the spring is F1, then this F1 will act in upward direction on the beam. So the force in the spring is just F1, whereas force at the end B of cantilever will be F minus F1, and this will be in the downward direction. So clearly we can see that the force in the spring and the force on the cantilever beam are different. So from these two, that is, they have same displacements and they have different forces, we can say that in this system the cantilever beam and the spring are connected in parallel. Now the stiffness of spring is known K, and the stiffness of cantilever beam can be written as 3EI upon L cube, and the equivalent stiffness of the cantilever beam and spring will be, because they are in parallel, KC plus K, and that will be equals to 3EI upon L cube plus K. Next, let's consider example of simply supported beam with spring, where the spring is connected at the midpoint of the simply supported beam and there is a force F acting at the midspan of the beam in downward direction. Now under the action of this force, the system will deform like this, and this, let's call this displacement of point B, YB in downward direction, and the spring will stretch like this. And here note that the displacement of the beam in downward direction is YB, and the stretching of the spring in the downward direction is also equals to YB. So both the beam and the spring have same displacement. And now if I draw free body diagram at point B for the beam and spring, then here note that the force in the spring, say, is F1, then on the beam we'll have F1 force in upward direction, and there is a force F in downward direction. So net force on the beam will be F minus F1 in downward direction, and the force in the spring will be F1. So here we see that the forces in the beam and spring are different. So here note that the beam and the spring have same displacement, and the forces in the beam and spring are different. So this implies that beam and spring are in parallel. Now because they are in parallel, then we can easily find their equivalent stiffness. This force F is in downward direction. Now the stiffness of simply supported beam acted by force F at the midspan in downward direction is KB equals to 48EI upon L cube, and because the spring and the simply supported beam are in parallel, so their equivalent stiffness will be KB plus K. So I can write K equivalent equals to 48EI upon L cubed plus K.